Good morning, everyone. Yesterday, a cherished heart friend of mine shared that a relative of hers is suffering from depression. And as I was showering this morning, a whole little download of a teaching came from either my higher self or one of the masters, and I'd like to share it with you. Because I feel that in this day and age, many people go through a time of depression. And many of us can even experience for temporary or short periods of time this state of feeling less than, that we're not living to our full capacity, and therefore something within us seems awry to the point where we just feel lowly, unworthy. We're unloved. Something's not right in our universe. And if we desire to call it depression or oppression, we can. So, regardless of the causes of all of this, which in some cases can be an imbalance in the biochemistry of the body temple through maybe not an optimal diet, what I received were impressions from the divine world of what we can do to counteract and to overcome depression. First and foremost, the sun is really the greatest impressor and example for us of one who 24/7 is radiant, effulgent, beautiful in its beingness and divine glory. We know of the teaching on SAD, S-A-D-D. And when people have enough sunshine, they often do not become depressed. People in northern climates, we know, suffer from this syndrome. So getting enough sun, direct sunlight, is very important. And if you are in a climate or an area where the sun is not available to you for long periods of time, having full-spectrum lighting in your home can at least facilitate there being the semblance of sunlight. Being in well-lit rooms with natural lighting is important for all of us. It's important for children's learning in school rather than using the types of lighting which are not full spectrum and therefore do not provide all of the ultraviolet radiation that is essential for our cells to be nurtured and nourished properly. God created the universe in a beautiful matrix, and the more we live within that natural order, the more easy it is for us to live natural lives of grace and harmony and beauty. So the sun is number one. Singing is one of the greatest divine stimulants to our hearts and our minds feeling the afflatus of the Holy Spirit, because our breath is engaged through singing. Often when we praise God or we're singing lovely songs, inspiring songs, we are lifted up. We become elated. We can have our spirits raised, literally, as well as figuratively. So singing engages the heart. It brings us happiness and joy. And of course, the best songs are those which do inspire, rather than singing the blues, which could bring more depressing energy. So choose your songs wisely so that they are ones that elevate and raise your spirit rather than bring them lower. Serving is really one of the greatest things that we can engage in to get our minds off of ourselves, our state of loneliness, or the woe is me consciousness. We can truly lose ourselves in service. And by that I mean lose the lesser self and gain the greater self. When we are engaged in helping others and serving and working, time flies. We feel the spirit moving through us. We're so focused on the needs of others and what it takes for us to provide them and to serve them and to love them, to cherish them, that we're outside of ourself, out of our little self, and we're really embraced by our greater God self, and the spirit does move through us. And in that spiritual energization that we feel through service, we are raised up out of the state of depression and oppression. Dancing and many forms of exercise that get our body temples moving are also one of the greatest ways to overcome the state. Think of how you felt when you've danced, when you're moving, when you're engaged in this rhythmic and sometimes maybe not so rhythmic movement of your body form that also elevates your breathing. And through dancing or other types of exercise, the Holy Spirit can move through you and activate the higher nerve centers within your brain and your body temple because you are moving. The spirit, the breath, is engaged. And oftentimes dancing is considered one of the best types of exercise, especially for us in our elder years. You probably have heard stories of people dancing in their 60s, 70s, 80s, and even 90s and more who live longer because they exercise through dance. And, of course, if you have a partner who's still alive in your elder years, it's fun to engage in this rhythmic activity with a beloved partner. Now, I've mentioned singing and dancing as forms where, excuse me, where we can do more pranic breathing, engage our breathing in a fantastic way. So breathing itself brings the Holy Spirit to bear within our worlds, and there is an energization of our entire being that happens when we breathe. Just one second here. I don't know who's calling. Hello?
Hi, David.
Hi. I'm giving a Discord.
I would be a little late, maybe possibly half an hour later.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Okay, so breathing is really important, and we've talked a lot about pranic breathing, and we know how important it is for us to really have the spirit of God flowing through our being. Another thing that I think that we don't always realize is that hydration, drinking enough water and pure, clean, unadulterated, crystal clear water, preferably spring water or fresh water out of the earth, is so important to us. So we know that the brain requires being hydrated in order to function properly. And what happens in an oppressed or depressed state? Well, our brains are not functioning at their optimal state. And often, hydrating and drinking enough water can simply add that X factor or Z factor, H2O factor, to bring us balance within our brain so that we don't have this mindset or problem where we succumb to attitudes or situations that bring us down. So for any of us who have at any time felt depressed, look almost immediately at whether you are being hydrated effectively, efficiently, through pure, wonderful spring water. And my wife tells me often that having teas and even juices does not quite do what we require. You have to have water which goes beyond the blood-brain barrier, and the liquid then gets to the cells in the brain. If you have teas and other liquids, they don't always get into the brain. The water doesn't within them doesn't get to the brain fully. So please consider hydrating enough. Don't drink Gatorade and things with a lot of sugar in them, because they are not really that healthy for us. I know a lot of sports athletes drink these Powerades and Gatorades, and unfortunately I believe that they're really not the optimal thing, even though they do have some electrolytes. You can have natural electrolytes that bring the balance within the cell tissues that you require for the sustenance of life and for perfect harmony. Also, a live diet is important, and whatever you can eat that has sunlight embedded within the cells of the food. Live food, lemons, limes, various fruits, berries of all kinds, especially fresh berries, as fresh as you can get them, will have that sunlight just resident within the cells of the food, which provides through that sunlight the impetus for an acceleration of consciousness, harmonizing and balancing effects. And we know now that all of these foods that have a high auric value are important for our longevity, for the building back of the cells and the sustaining of the cells and the restoration of cells that maybe have degenerated a little bit. So there are many foods and even other drinks now which have a high auric value because they contain blueberry juice, strawberry, raspberry, and acai, and or acai if you pronounce it that way, many other amazing berries which have been discovered in the last few decades, which have a very high energy field within them because they have been exposed to the sun and they have this concentrated solar energy within them and thereby have the radiance of that sun which can raise our spirits as we partake of them. Also, bee pollen, royal jelly, and honey, and other bee products, I believe, are very, very good for us to elevate our consciousness and to bring through that concentration of the sun within the pollen itself into our body temples as we partake of them. I have a source of pollen right where I live, not too far away, and I buy $100 at a time, a huge bag of, I don't know, it's 10 or 15 pounds, and so that lasts an entire year, typically, at the rate that we consume pollen. So if you have not partaken of bee pollen yet, I encourage you, especially those of you who live in northern climates, who could really benefit from having this substance within your body temple, because in the wintertime, there's less sunlight for you. Finally, creative work, I think, is so important. And I touched on service, helping others. However, any type of creative work where you engage your mind, your heart, your imagination, your hands, in offering to humanity something of your spirit through the gifts, the graces, the blessings that you've been given by God, I believe bring us out of this state of depression, because when creativity is flowing, there's simply no place within us. There's no space within us to feel depressed or oppressed by anything else that's going on outside. When we are truly engaged in our highest work, time flies, as I said before, and it's amazing how our days can just have this infusion of a sense of uplift and beauty and reverence that really supports our spiritual health. So this is what I received this morning, and I'm sure that some of you could add other factors which have assisted you. However, these are the components that I feel that are so important for us. Now, some people take drugs in order to attempt to get out of this state of depression, psychoactive drugs, drugs, and drugs that are even authorized by the FDA or the doctors prescribe. I encourage us to do everything else possible to sustain the state of equipoise and balance and harmony within our beings before coming to the point where we may feel that we have to have a prescription drug, an antidepressant. If you look at what's transpired in the world at large today, I believe that many of these drugs, which possibly well-meaning doctors prescribe, are actually counterintuitive to our optimal health, keep us in this kind of drugged-down state. And, you know, what happens when you have these mood swings where you go up and down and up and down and you require these drugs? Well, it's not bringing the harmony and balance that we especially require to maintain a state of peace, inner peace, beingness, and inner joy and happiness. So there's an article that David Lewis, the other David Lewis, who owns and is the editor of the Montana Pioneer, published in his most recent January edition. And it was very interesting. It was a medical doctor who is a psychiatrist who has never prescribed antidepressants or any other drugs. She works with alternative therapies and with counseling, and she facilitates the natural restoration of the balance of the mind and the heart within the individual, often through right diet, because oftentimes people can be out of balance because of things that they may have taken in through the environment, through their bodies, through drugs themselves, and even through inoculations. So she says that she feels that drugs are often at the very core of the problem we see with some of these individuals who are going off the deep end and then involved in killing others, such as we saw in Newtown, Connecticut, recently, right before or at the time that we left on our pilgrimage to Peru. So let us pray for all those who may temporarily be in a state of depression or may have long-term issues with the situation because of various factors. There are influences of our parents, of our families, that often bring a spirit of oppression to us when they are not supportive of us. And even of bosses or in job situations where we feel devalued, unappreciated. Let us pray for each one who may be in any way moving through this trial within their life of experiencing a state of non-happiness, non-fulfillment, to be inspired by angels of beauty. Divine. You know, the angels are one of the best facilitators of a highly elated state of divine bliss and beingness. And if I could add one thing to what I shared before, it would be prayer, and especially prayer to the archangels, the archei, and the ascended masters. The angels bring to bear within our worlds such a divine state of happiness, holiness, healthiness, the three H's. And I believe that when we are in tune with the angels, and when we sing, and when we pray, and when we dance, and when we engage the angels in all of our work each day, we really cannot help but be happy and fulfilled, holy, and uplifted and supported. And there's no place for depression, oppression, anxiety in the state of communion with the higher worlds through the angels who so love us and bring the virtues of God to bear in our lives in such a graceful and beautiful way. So when we develop relationships with the angels, when we expect the angels to be there, and we invite them into our worlds consciously through prayers each morning, that state of hallowedness and sanctity resides within our worlds, our homes, our job places, our job sites, so that they can help sustain an aura, an ambience of vitality and love and cherishment and fulfillment, so that we, even through hard times and even through difficult toil or hard labor, can feel supported and loved and appreciated. So the angels are really our greatest cohorts in this means of providing the impetus that we all require to feel fulfilled and supported. They are our greatest friends, divine benefactors. And as we get to know the various angels, archangels, and even our own guiding angel, our own guardian angel, our guardian spirit, it provides for us that special extra grace that we require to move through the difficulties in life, the challenges of today, the darkness of the Kali Yuga, and these times when so much war, destruction, poverty, death are occurring around us. We can move through any disaster, seeming disaster, with the aid of God, supported by, protected by the angels. When we give our 23rd Psalm, the angels come and they support us. They build a ring of spiritual fire around us because we place our trust in God. Archangel Michael and his great hosts are there always at our beck and call. Simply saying Michael brings this great divine being right to where we are to protect us at any hour of the day or night. When we get to know Raphael, Gabriel, Uriel, Zachiel, Uziel, Jophiel, and Chamuel, and, of course, the five crystal ray angels and their archei, they can weave around us a support system of light and an energy field of beingness that, by God's grace, we can be supported and uplifted so that we never descend into these states of feeling that we must take our lives, or in an unloved state have no friends, or that simply we must do something drastic to change our situation. From an early age, I developed a love through Jesus and Mary and Joseph of the Holy Family, and feeling the energy of the Holy Family within my family for decades, and looking to these great divine beings who so love us and support us day by day, provides a familial uplift that really has been amazing for me throughout my life. Because I love to give the rosary, to pray to Mother Mary, to see her immaculate heart beating within my own breast, to feel the currents of her love, to feel the same from the Sacred Heart of Jesus or the purple fiery heart of Saint Germain, as our beloved Saint Joseph, provides such a beautiful experience on a daily basis. And I believe that by God's grace, I've avoided states of depression simply by being in tune with the Holy Family and their radiance, their love, their amazing hearts of fire that provide such a beautiful resource of divine energy and light that I know who I am. I can move through the various challenges, even temporary setbacks with health challenges or with those who may not understand my path, who may even, you know, be praying against what we're doing with the Heart Center. They may have their concepts of who and what we are based on just ignorance or misunderstandings. So don't let others' matrix upon you create around you a box, a cage, a limiting environment that you at times succumb to feel in this state of depression. Create around yourself an aura of perfect presence. Picture perfect presence and peace by allowing your presence to flow, by allowing your presence to sing, by engaging in these activities, being in the sun, singing, serving, exercising, especially dancing, breathing deeply with pranic breathing, hydration with enough essential water, with a live diet as much as possible, living foods supercharged by the sun, and by your creative work to allow your spirit to feel fulfilled, blessed by God's light and love. Thank you for listening today. I appreciate who you are, each and every one. And I know what some of you have been through, that it's been dramatic, even diabolical, of having to weather the storms of life. Because I think that we've all experienced at times the treachery of the darkness itself and what it would attempt to do to snuff out our lives. So be at peace with yourself, love yourself, cherish who you are as a God-created being, and accept that even with your imperfections, even with your human peccadilloes and inconsistencies on the path, or at times your seeming failures, God is present within you. The light is within your heart. Your threefold flame is the God light within your heart that is constantly providing this effulgence of beingness that gives you your life itself. So focus on light and life, and as you do, you will live a sublime and beautiful life. God bless you. Have an awesome day and week. Bye-bye.